Hi, it's Jennifer from Soul Source Tarot, and I'm here to do your daily vibes for Monday, Tuesday. So the 17th, 18th, I already did one, but it was long. It was really, really long, and some people are, oh, I don't want them that long. So, whatever. I don't know, I might share it, I might not. This is for Monday, Tuesday. We'll see what comes up. I did see that we had the Lover's card, so that was real good. I did do it with the Vice Versa deck. There's somebody coming in to help you heal, all right? There is. There's somebody coming in to help you heal after you turn your back on a dead end. Same story, right? Well, hopefully we can get another one this time. But I do see that there's a new lover. There is. And we had the Devil as well, so there's a lot of desires there. There's a strong attraction between you and another person. We had this card and this card and this card. Those are the only repeating cards, these three cards. Different deck, though, I used. So it appears that there's an opportunity for security and stability here. Okay, with the Ten of Pentacles, that maybe perhaps somebody is starting to begin a new legacy, or they're thinking about their legacy. There's indecision as to whether to move on or not. Do I move on? Do I stay or not? And I'm so sick of this shit. I mean, it's sickening. Do I stay or do I go? If you have to question it, that should be your answer. Do I stay or do I go? Don't talk to me like that. Somebody needs a kick in the fucking ass. Do I stay or do I go? I don't have the balls to make a move. My fears are driving this situation, and I refuse to listen to my intuition. It's okay. It's okay for me to be taken advantage of. It is. I will continue to be naive because I am afraid to get on that boat and move on because I need to face pain. I'm scared of pain. Therefore, I am blocking my own happiness. Living in denial, trying to escape, living a fantasy. They're coming back. That's a fantasy, my dear. Complete fantasy. You're lying to yourself. You're not treating yourself with integrity. You're not having integrity for your worth, for yourself. You don't have the backbone, like I said, the balls. To move on. You're thinking about it. Your intuition is telling you to walk away. But it's just a thought. Because that fantasy and illusion is real. It's real. That fantasy is real. That fantasy is blocking your rebirth. Fear of change. You're restricting yourself from love. You're restricting yourself from happiness, from abundance, from security. Staying in the safest option, staying where it's safe, protecting yourself through fantasy. Refusing to deal with the pain. You have to face the pain. You have to. There's a new opportunity for love. A new beginning. If you love yourself enough, new love will come in. Temperance, healing. This is a card of healing as well. Renewal. This is a card of renewal as well. It is time for renewal. It is time to move on. It's time to bring peace and harmony and balance and self-love and self-worth and self-respect back to your life. It's time to go after wish fulfillment. And you know what? There's an opportunity for wish fulfillment after you close a door and you decide to really move on. There's an opportunity for love. For those of you that have changed, you have released, you have let go. For those of you that have healed, we have love. Love is here for those of you that have healed. Love and wish fulfillment. Abundance. For those of you that are still hanging on to a fantasy, you're blocking love. Fantasy blocking love. You have to allow this to happen. You have to allow it. Trying to control never works out. You cannot make somebody love you. Clinging to control. Thinking that, you know, I can make this happen. I can make this happen. You can't make anything happen. The only thing you can make happen is your soul. You can make your soul transform. That's the only thing that you can make happen. Everything happens for a purpose. Doors close and doors open for a purpose. People come in and people go out. Doesn't matter what the purpose is. It doesn't. It doesn't matter what the purpose is. All that matters is growth, love, love. Everybody deserves love. Trying to, or holding on to a fantasy is blocking love. Real love, true love. It's time to evolve. It's time to get to the other side of that pain and allow this rebirth to happen. Because I want these messages to change. There's an opportunity for love, security, wish fulfillment, balance, peace, harmony. But you have to look at things from a new perspective. You need to be wise. You need to assert yourself. You need to stand up for yourself. You need to cut playing games. You need to cut your ego out of the equation. We all have it. Rejection. And that's why people hang on to fantasies, because they were rejected, and the ego, the pride is so big that they can't just accept it and move on. That's what that is. There's an opportunity for love here, there is. But you have to be open to it. You have to see it. You have to see it. But going backwards isn't going to get you nowhere. Nowhere. Somebody's trying to control destiny. Living in a fantasy. Needing to look at this in a different light. Whatever it is that you are staying in that is making you so unhappy, has caused you to lose your focus and your concentration, you're not listening to your intuition, whatever it is, is bringing you backwards, and you can't control it. You can't control this. There's a birth of something new for those of you that have healed, okay? For those of you that have not, you need to get serious here. You need to get serious. Come back down to reality. And stop blocking the birth of something new. You are blocking the birth of something new by living in fantasy land, okay? For those of you that are, I mean, that is the case here. Wanting to move on, not listening to your intuition because the fantasy is so big. And it's only bringing you backwards because you're trying to control it. When there's an opportunity for something new, if you could just realize what you were worth. Just so you know, I mean, the Wheel of Fortune reversed, that's bad luck. Bad luck. Somebody isn't doing the right thing. And when you don't act with integrity and you don't do the right thing, even then when you know what the right thing is to do, but who knows why you're not doing it? Maybe you thought it was love. Who knows? Okay? Somebody is holding on to something that is a fantasy, but whatever. And it's bringing them bad luck. It's bringing them backwards. Because you can't control it. You cannot control it. Somebody's trying to escape as well. Escape the reality of what is. Anyway, for those of you that have healed, there's an opportunity for something new. For those of you that have not, you're still living in fantasy land. time to realize what you're worth, what you deserve. What's meant to be will be. You can't control it. It's not in your control. Fantasy blocking love. If you could realize that there's a purpose why things don't work out. There's always something going on behind the scenes in the universe. That with endings bring new beginnings. There's an opportunity for love here. New love. But trying to control the situation, putting the name on it, is a no-no. You can't control the script, even though you may think that you can. But that's, somebody thinks that they're, you know, whatever. Being naive. So anyway, I feel like there is an opportunity for wish fulfillment with someone new. For those of you that have went through a renewal of some sort, a rebirth. Somebody's bringing bad luck into their life. I mean, they are. Because they're refusing to go through that new door. They're refusing to go down the new path. You know, holding on to something that is hurting them. Like I always say, you have to feel the pain. You have to feel the pain to get to this miracle, to get to this love. Pushing it aside and living in a fantasy is just gonna hurt you even more. You have to. You gotta cut somebody out. You gotta cut somebody out because you deserve love. Somebody's being taken advantage of. They're allowing it. They are absolutely allowing it. You need to move on. You do. You need to move on from this situation that has no growth. Because you've grown. Okay? You have. You have. You've grown. Why? Anyway, I feel like there's an opportunity for love here for those of you that have healed. Could lead to something stable, could learn to lead to wish fulfillment, could lead to a lot of happiness. For those of you that are still living in fantasy land, you have to love yourself enough to say, I want more. This isn't right. Somebody's refusing to walk away from a player. Okay? I mean, I can't make this shit up. That's your own fault. The Empress is a woman, I mean, we've talked about this, who knows her worth, okay? She knows her worth. She doesn't chase people or opportunities because she's so beautiful. She has a lot of life experience. She's been through hell and back. This is who the Empress is. She's been through hell and back. And she's taken those experiences and she's learned from them, okay? She has learned from them. And now she knows that she will not put up with anything at all. If you do not value me, if you do not respect me, if you want to go play games, if you want to go play games with other people, then you're not worth it because I am worth more than that. I am a beautiful soul. She knows who she is. She knows exactly who she is. Like I said, she's been through to hell and back. She knows what she's worth. For those of you that are in Empress mode and you know what you are worth, here it comes. For those of you that don't know what you're worth, and you're still living in fantasy land with a player, you have to love yourself. You need to get into Empress mode. The Empress does not deal with players. She's in control, not him. Somebody has given the control, somebody has, over to a man who's not even in the fucking picture. How sad is that? Pretty sad. Talk to you next time.